My name is Danny Rosales, or Danny Otister Rosales, now that I'm married. And I graduated May 2018 this year, and I work at Big Brothers Big Sisters as a program specialist. So Big Brothers Big Sisters is a nonprofit organization. It is national, although each state has its own kind of, it's almost like if a nonprofit was a franchise. So, you know, I report directly to our state office. But what we do is we pair volunteer mentors with at-risk youth just to, you know, empower them and defend their potential and make sure that we're just allowing them to really have access to all of these great opportunities that they may not otherwise have access to, whether it be because of their backgrounds or because they need a role model there due to an absent parent or just an unstable parent figure being around. But really, it's just about measuring those tangible outcomes, making sure that we can get them to graduate high school, potentially go to college, and try to get these matches to be long-lasting. I mean, we look at shared interests, of course. I've had some matches before where the little's really interested in being an engineer, and we just so happen to have a lot of bigs around Tulsa who are engineers. We do have a lot of for-profit organizations in town that really pretty much encourage their employees to come to us and volunteer. They see that as really rewarding. So we do have a lot of just like bigs plugged into all these different professional networks, and that makes a really great match when you have that little who has this like fire in them to become something, and you have the big who is that something. So they get to like look up to that and see that it's doable, and they have that person as a mentor. I think, you know, I got out of college, right, and my ultimate goal later on down the line is to go back to grad school and get my PhD in sociology and get into that academic world, which can be like so dense, and you know, it's got a lot of gatekeeping, and there's just a lot of it's a really interesting world to navigate. And I really needed to jump into a nonprofit where I could reconnect with that sort of like tangible like community, so that once I do go back into academia, I can always have that in mind and never write things that are completely inaccessible to the public. You know, if your revolution is inaccessible, then it's not really a revolution, right? So I don't ever want to be that professor who's just like writing really, really stuffy work that nobody can understand unless they've been through all these things. So I wanted to, you know, work at a nonprofit where I was going to engage with people who, you know, who weren't academics, first of all, and also just engage with just everybody. And this like helps me to do that, because it's not just, you know, the kind of the families that we work with who tend to be of lower socioeconomic statuses or just come from even just different kinds of trauma in their history. But I'm also engaging with these bigs who are a range of socioeconomic statuses. Some of the biggest names in Tulsa are bigs, but then also some people that, you know, you would, you know, just somebody who just graduated high school and they just want to give back, that's also a big. So I get to engage with a really, really broad variety of people. And another thing I really like about Big Brothers Big Sisters is that although it's a sort of individualistic approach to all of these, you know, to these individual child's needs, it acknowledges the systemic issue as a whole. So we all look at that and understand why these families are coming to us. We understand why the time commitment is an issue. And we kind of look at all of these systemic barriers that are in place, and we know that we're doing a small individual part to help, but there's certainly other resources that we can help connect them to that we know are helping on a more structural level.